Since I was a kid, I always liked to mess around with the sounds. Play keys, pull strings, tweak knobs, and hear the result immediately. This world fascinates me to this day, and I still love it. Like magic. Hi, my name is Roman Seliverstov, and this is my studio. Every day I'm looking for new musical tricks. Doesn't matter if I'm writing music or doing production, it's like solving a puzzle. You add sounds or subtract, trying this or trying that, but nobody will tell you which answer is right. The result will always be a surprise. In every song or score there is a basis, a simple thing that glues everything together. And there is a creative part. That's where its potential is revealed. I mean, after all these centuries pass, the notes are still the same and all the rules of arrangement seem to be as open. But everyone who does music has a desire to do something new, find their own style and show it to the people. Therefore, we're like predators, hunting for new ideas, new tools and new instruments all the time. I like to combine proven solutions and creative things. Nowadays, producer or composer is constantly working with virtual instruments. It's convenient, fast, and they are really cool now, but I've always lacked some kind of imperfections in it. That vital imperfections that exist in the real world and in real synthesizers. I'm looking for all the new ways to make them sound different, and Elysia helps me a lot. I pass different instruments and virtual synthesizers through Karacter to add live elements to it, something that is impossible in the digital world, and then I print it back to the computer. For example, I used Elysia on many sources on the last score, even on a large symphonic orchestra. We recorded it at Abbey Road and old desk. What else is needed? But I wanted to make a parallel track with a copy of an orchestra processed through Karacter and blend it with a real one. It might look like a very strange decision, but it worked out great. I would like to show you different ways of using Elysia Karacter and demonstrate how I use it in my work. I really like various synth arpeggios, and I often use Karacter with aggressive settings to emphasize some changes in melody. When you strengthen this effect at the end of the section, the part works with a groove much better and retains a sense of a continuous movement, adding accents to the transitions. I have a couple of examples with and without Karacter. Here is a good example used in cinema music a lot. Such arpeggiators often set a pace of the scene. It doesn't sound bad as is, but listen to how bright and lively it sounds with Karacter applied. With high frequency content added, it became more percussive. Playing with the Karacter, I decided to try it with the long bass notes on the piano. It seemed to me that it sounds creative and well-suited for both soundtracks and creative accents in dance music and even pop rock songs, especially if you add shimmer reverb. Check this out. Okay, now let's hear it with character. And now let's add shimmer to it. I think it sounds really cool and powerful, almost a complete movie trailer. It's also cool to use character with already driven guitars. This results in a strange effect, slightly resembling a beat crusher, but still different. Let's listen to how it sounds using an example of a guitar riff. Listen to that. Sound like bacon on frying pan. I've had a couple of tracks where such a strange sound came in handy. At small values, character brings life to pads on VST synthesizers. It sounds as if it is emphasizing them. They come out and become clearer, more analog sounding. It's hard to put this into words. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. Okay, sounds more interesting. Here's another example. Let's set up character and listen how it sounds after processing. Character works nicely with drums as well. I use it the same way as you would use parallel compression or EQ. I blend clean drum track with its copy modified with character, which has pretty aggressive settings. Let's listen to how it sounds with character. Here's what they sound like together. As you can hear with a certain balance, this doesn't interfere with the dynamics and timbre of the drums, but adds punch quite noticeably. I hope that my way of using character was interesting and useful for you, and gave you a lot of creative ideas that you will try in your tracks. One of the character's main advantages is the flexibility of configuring. It's easy to configure for a specific situation, either almost imperceptibly or very aggressive. Character seems to me as an excellent saturator, with a special and very recognizable sound. Thank you for watching this video. Bye!